Okay, so we were discussing about the dispersion here. The two points of importance are, in order to avoid this overlapping, okay, for no overlapping condition for the light pulses in the optical fiber, the bit rate, the condition is the bit rate, that is BT, it should be less than 1 by 2 tau. And this tau is the pulse broadening time duration. Okay, kisne time pe aapka pulse broad ho raha hai, that is tau. This is the condition. Now, one more accurate estimate we can get it for this maximum bit rate. How? By considering the whatever light pulses are coming out at the output, they are having the Gaussian shape, Gaussian distribution curve, okay? But it is having the width, say, rho. That is the assumption, okay? We will consider with this, we will get the more accurate value of this maximum bit rate. This analysis, what is the advantage of this if we consider Gaussian distribution? This will allow us for the existence of certain amount of signal overlap, even though some amount of overlap exists with this Gaussian distribution estimate, even though certain overlapping exists, but this, you know, SNR can be avoided with this whenever ISI becomes pronounced. Because whenever dispersion occurs, overlapping occurs. Because of pulse broadening, overlapping, and ISI becomes more prominent. And error rate, this causes errors. And error rate is dependent on both attenuation and SNR. So we can avoid SNR, okay, to the extent if we consider Gaussian distribution. And the formula for this maximum bit rate is given by BT max is equal to 0.2 divided by this rho. Rho is the pulse width. Whenever we have considered the Gaussian distribution, this width is rho. Okay. Now, if we want to, bit rate is nothing but if we want to take this bit rate in terms of bandwidth, that is in terms of hertz, right? Bandwidth is expressed in terms of hertz. Bit rate is expressed in terms of bits per second. So if we want this conversion from bit rate to the bandwidth, if we want the required bandwidth, it actually depends upon the type of coding format which we are using. You have studied different coding techniques in case of digital communication, NRZ coding, RZ coding, few more. Okay, you can mention few more if you know. So for different coding techniques, so this conversion, the value is different. Here I have listed two for two coding formats, the value of the bandwidth. So this BT max is equal to 2 times B. This is your bit rate, okay? Bit rate is equal to 2 times the bandwidth, or the if we want the bandwidth, bandwidth will be in terms of hertz. Bit rate will be in terms of bits per second, right? You write kbps, mbps, so bits per second. So if this is the formula, BT max is equal to 2 times bandwidth. Bandwidth is given by BT max by 2. This formula is for NRZ coding. But if you consider RZ coding format, and the formula will be simply no 2 times. It is simply the bandwidth is equal to your BT max. Okay, these are the two values. How we can convert bit rate into the bandwidth. Bandwidth will be in terms of hertz. Now, look at these three figures. We have these figures which will give you three optical fiber structures. One is a multimode step index, second one multimode graded index, third one single mode step index. In module one, we have studied first step index, graded index. Then in each of these single mode, multimode, okay? Out of these different structures, we have considered these three. You can see, first one is a multimode step index. Multimodes, see different light is propagating through different modes. Here only two rays I have shown you, okay? Two modes it is propagating. You can see there is a slight difference. Here it is, touching the interface here, and it is total internal reflection is occurring. And the point is somewhere here, okay? Actually, I should have shown somewhere like this. Both will not be same because different modes will have different angles, right? And the angles at which they got incident and the reflection, PIR, criteria is different for each ray. So these are not symmetric actually. So I have drawn this structure. The rays are only two, but it is multimode, more than one. And this structure we have already seen. If you remember, we have seen this kind of structure in while studying the refractive index profiles, while studying the step index, graded index, you can see there is a constant value. This whatever refractive index profile is there, it is constant throughout in the cladding region. After that, there is a step kind of structure. But that's why it is called step index fiber. We have already explained about this. This is vertical distance is the radial distance, and this horizontal axis, it is giving you the refractive index. So this is the refractive index profile of the multimode step index fiber. Now, these two things already we have studied. Now, look at these two things. Assume करो कि ये आपका input है optical fiber के लिए, ये आपका output होगा. Okay? And this pattern is the same for every structure. Three structures I have shown you here. For every three, each of these structures, refractive index profile I have drawn. Then how the waves are inside, the modes are there inside. Then what is the input, what is the output for each of these structures. So coming to the first structure, observe what is the input and what is the output. See, somewhere you can take some pulse also, okay, depending upon the coding format, you can take any input. This is your pulse. If this is the input, you can see, ideally, you should have got something like this. Because input jo hum de rahe hain, information, it has to be received as it is. Ideally, we should have got like this. But what pulse we are getting here, observe, we are getting something like this. Okay, so the pulse is broadened. You can see the broadening duration, width kitna hai, you can observe. This is for multimode step index fiber. Okay, now for a comparative study, we can go for multimode graded index fiber. Graded index means you can see, there is a common point where all these light waves, they meet, these rays meet and they will divert. And again, they will meet. In this way, the wave propagation occurs inside the multimode graded index fiber. This you have already studied. Okay, there is what? A curve, the variation. It is at the center, it is maximum. You have already seen this. Okay, we have studied about the graded index fiber already. Coming to this point. This is your input. If either it is a pulse or some wave, okay, anyway, whatever you want to take, take it. If this is the input, observe the output. After some distance, there is some broadening, not too much. Yahan pe jo earlier case mein tha, you observe, you compare this width and this width, broadening of the pulse. Ye thoda zyada extent mein broad hua hai. And this is comparatively small. Okay, I should have drawn it a little bit greater than this. Okay, the amplitudes are different. They should be same. So, iska jo broadening hai, this is less compared to the earlier figure. Now, coming to the third figure. This is the refractive index profile of a single mode step index fiber. And the difference between this graded and step index, we had discussed. Core diameter small rahega, right? There is a very small core diameter so that one only single ray can pass through it. Okay, hair like. Observe this. If this is the pulse, it is almost the same. Okay, almost the same. So the dispersion or pulse broadening effect, the inter-symbol interference, it can be avoided in a single mode step index fiber if you compare it with the first two. In first case, multimode step index, it is too much. The broadening is too much. If you compare it with the graded index, a little bit, you know, improved performance. Okay, it is little bit. There is a broadening, but compared to the first, it is a bit less. And for the third, single mode step index, it is almost no broadening. So the same thing I have explained it here. In multimode step index, first case, greatest dispersion of the transmission light. In the multimode second one, graded index fiber, considerably some improvement in the performance. Broadening hai, but lesser. In third, single mode fiber, we have minimum, okay, nil, almost nil, minimum pulse broadening is observed, okay, in these three figures. And the last one, the single mode fiber, it is capable of greatest transmission bandwidth. So even in the earlier concepts, when we were dealing with module 1, we have seen that, we have discussed about this, the greater transmission bandwidths are for single mode fibers compared to the multi-mode fibers. Advantages and disadvantages, this was one of the, we have listed this one of the advantage of single mode. Pulse broadening jitna hoga, aapka bandwidth kam hoga. Okay, the information carrying capability of the fiber will reduce if dispersion increases. Okay, and the same thing I have just written, just for your information, I have written like this. Jitna dispersion hoga, bandwidth kam hoga, information carrying capacity kam ho jayega. Now, the amount of pulse broadening. हमने फर्स्ट थ्री फिगर्स यू कैन सी हमने ये तीन फिगर्स डिस्कस किए हैं द अमाउंट ऑफ पल्स ब्रॉडनिंग यू कैन सी यहाँ पे थोड़ा ज्यादा है हियर इट इज मॉडरेट हियर इट इज ऑलमोस्ट निल ओके सो दिस अमाउंट ऑफ पल्स ब्रॉडनिंग इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द डिस्टेंस द पल्स ट्रेवल्स विद इन द फाइबर ओके कितना डिस्टेंस वो ट्रेवल करता है विद इन द फाइबर इट डिपेंड्स ऑन दैट Hence, for a given optical fiber link, the restriction on the usable bandwidth is, it can be determined by the distance between the regenerative repeaters. Why we use the repeaters at certain intervals? Because the signal strength gets reduced because of some losses or dispersion. So repeaters se kya hoga? Again, signal strength will be boosted and we, again, you know, back to the original. We will try to reconstruct the original signal. Jo bhi loss hua hai, usko hum compensate karte hain using the repeaters. So how we can have this? The restriction on the usable bandwidth, it can be determined or dictated by the distance between the regenerative repeaters. Hence, the dispersion measurement of a particular fiber, how we measure the dispersion measurement on an optical fiber or dispersion properties of an optical fiber, you can even say, it is stated as the pulse broadening in time over a unit length of the fiber. How we measure this dispersion, the pulse broadening in time over a unit length of the fiber. If this is a total length, per unit length, hum jitna pulse broad ho raha hai, okay? Assume karo, this is your per unit length. Itne length mein kitna pulse broad ho raha hai? That is the dispersion measurement of an optical fiber. The number of optical signal pulses that may be transmitted in a given period, that is nothing but your bandwidth itself, right? Bit rate, what you call. Jitne pulse within a second, how much within a that time interval, kitna pass kar sakte ho signal ko, that is nothing but your bandwidth. So bandwidth is restricted by the amount of pulse dispersion per unit length. Obviously, jitna dispersion zyada hoga, aapka bandwidth restrict ho hi jayega, right? Information bearing capability will be reduced. Now, the this is one of the parameter used by the manufacturers. Whenever optical fiber cables, if you just look into their specifications, this will be specified by the manufacturers. Bandwidth length product. This is one parameter. This is used, you know, the significance of this parameter is for comparative study. Jitna value zyada hai, you know, uska durability, the significance of that particular fiber, we can decide on that. So it is one comparative parameter. You can see bandwidth length product, bandwidth into the length. For multi-mode step index fiber, the first figure, first, second, and third. Okay, multi-mode step index, multi-mode graded index, then a single mode step index. Ye teen jo diagrams humne dekha hai yahan pe, these first, second, and third. For these three, what is this bandwidth length product? The value is 20 megahertz. Hertz kilometer, bandwidth is in hertz, length is in kilometer. So 20 megahertz, 1 gigahertz, 100 gigahertz. So you can see the values, they are increasing. जितना इसका वैल्यू ज्यादा है, यू नो यू कैन कंपेयर, हमको पल्स ब्रॉडनिंग कहां मिनिमम मिलेगा, हियर. सो ये वैल्यू जितना ज्यादा है, इट मींस पल्स ब्रॉडनिंग, यू कैन कंपेयर द वैल्यूज. हियर देयर इज कंपैरेटिवली लेसर और यू नो निल, द पल्स ब्रॉडनिंग इज निल इन केस ऑफ सिंगल मोड स्टेप इंडेक्स फाइबर. बट इफ यू कंपेयर इट विद द फर्स्ट केस, see 20 megahertz kilometer, the value is less compared to the remaining two. What does that indicate? It is indicating that the much pulse broadening is there in the first case. Okay, so bandwidth length product, this is one parameter. It is helpful for comparing the performance. Okay, there is a problem here. You just go through the problem. A multimode graded index fiber, it exhibits a pulse broadening of 0.1 microsecond. See, dispersion or pulse broadening hum seconds mein measure karte hain, unit of time. Okay, jitna broad hua hai, how much time it has broadened, so it is measured in seconds. So pulse, total pulse broadening is 0.1 microsecond over a distance of 15 kilometer. See, ye jo hai pulse broadening over a total 15 kilometer, itna pulse broadening hua hai. Okay, not per kilometer or per unit length. It is the total value it is given. Estimate the maximum possible bandwidth on the link. Okay, assuming no ISI. So, link, optical fiber link ka bandwidth kya hoga? That is the first question. Second question, we need to find the pulse dispersion per unit length. This is for total length. We need to find per unit length. Then bandwidth length product. So here there is no specific coding format is given to you. It's simply multimode graded index they have mentioned. So what I will do for RZ coding, okay, because for RZ coding it is bandwidth is equal to BT. Already we have seen this in the previous slide. You can see for RZ coding, bandwidth is equal to bitrate maximum. If you want to go with NRZ, you should consider bandwidth. How to find the bandwidth? Bitrate divided by 2 you have to do. But I am taking the RZ coding. So for RZ coding, the maximum possible bandwidth is equal to the bitrate. But what is bitrate? We have already seen the condition. 1 divided by 2 tau. Tau is the pulse broadening. The value is already given to you, 0.1 microsecond. So tau value is given, 0.1 into 10 raised to minus 6. So apply the formula, you will get the bandwidth of the optical fiber. Second is dispersion per unit length. So jo bhi dispersion aapko diye hai, 0.1 microsecond pulse broadening, it is for overall 15 kilometer. But if you want to find per kilometer, divide it by 15. Don't use a kilometer again here because it is a per kilometer itself. K will be as it is. So 0.1 into 10 raised to minus 6 divided by 15. You just check out what answer you get. You write it here. And the third one is bandwidth length product. So bandwidth, just now we have got 5 megahertz. And what is the length given? 15 kilometers. So multiply, you will get 75 megahertz kilometer. Okay, for this multimode graded index fiber, we have got this bandwidth length product, 75 megahertz kilometer. There is one more way of finding this bandwidth length product. How? It is nothing but your 1 by 2 tau, that is your bitrate. It is equal. So 1 divided by 2 into, so what is tau value? Tau value for overall, it is given as 0.1 microseconds for 15 kilometer. But here, when you are finding the bandwidth length product, don't take overall. Take the per unit length value. So here we have calculated per unit length value. How much? 6.67. Don't take 0.1. Take the second value. Dispersion per unit length mein jo answer aaya hai aapko, you take that as the tau here, only when you are calculating the bandwidth length product. Okay, so it is 1 divided by 2 into this, approximately you will get 74.96, which is up to 75 only. So dono answers aapke same hi aayenge. Either you can go with this or you can go with this. So this is how the dispersion occurs. Okay. Generally, assume karo aap, agar ek optical fiber hai aapke paas, I'll just show you one simple structure. This is your optical fiber. Core material. And using some source like a laser or LED, you are launching the light ray. It will enter and assume that multi-mode mein hai wo, okay? Rays passing through multi-modes. Many number of modes exist. When the light is launched, here inside it will propagate through different modes. Okay, this is one mode. Let me use different colors just to show you. One more, maybe something like this. The other one, maybe something like this. Okay. Now, compare all the three diagrams, the three rays. Okay, I have just shown you three modes. Okay, multi-mode mein, sirf three modes have drawn the rays. Now, whenever a light wave is launched here, it is launched at once, right? So we are getting this light wave from the LED or any source that is laser at once. Sabhi at once humko milenge. But when it will travel inside, check the structure. This red color. Okay, this wave. 1, 2, 3, 4. So four times a total internal reflection happened for red color. Coming to yellow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Assume for yellow color ray, 5 total internal reflections. Coming to the blue color. Check the blue color. 1, 2, 3. So only 3 times. So whenever you're taking the output at the other side, expected is humne information at once send kiya hai. But inside, when it passes, it is passing through different configurations, different modes. I have drawn you three modes here. In the three modes, observe the length of the ray inside. Jitni bar wo internal reflection ho raha hai, number you can see. Out of this three rays, blue color ray will reach first. Okay, then red and then yellow color. Even though at once humne information transmit kiya hai, information is a packet. But at the end, we are receiving these values differently. Definitely, what? It is very haphazard. Your information you cannot receive as it is. So this is the meaning of dispersion. When you are sending your information at once, inside the optical fiber, when the rays are passing through different modes, because of this structure, because of these total internal reflection, what I have shown you, the longer path some has to travel, some rays have to travel shorter paths, because of which, whichever will have shorter path, they will reach the receiver first. So, ye kya hai? Ye distortion hai. Okay, this is what? The loss of the signal. Hope you understood this part. Today we have seen what is a dispersion, what is the condition for dispersion, that is a bit rate, it should be less than or equal to 1 by 2 tau. Then we have seen for three different optical fibers, multi-mode, step index, graded index and single mode, what is the pulse broadening, okay, amount, wo single mode fiber mein kam rahega, multi-mode first one, step index mein zyada rahega. And also we have seen about the bandwidth length product. This is one parameter used for comparing the different optical fibers. And we have seen one problem. In the next session, we will be looking into the classification. That is, I have shown you the classification intramodal dispersion and intermodal dispersion. So we will be discussing that in the next session.